All right, so we are on sequence 8 of 9. You'll have a good chunk of the areas to clean up. Here, do all that through the story. Or sorry, do all that, when I'm mopping up collectibles and stuff like that. Right now, just gonna plow ahead with the story. I believe our first one that we're gonna be doing is Strange Bedfellows, I think. I will check my list from TA. I think that might actually be the only mission available. So yeah, we're gonna have to do that one. All right, it's kind of like right between you, so we might as well just. All right, mission's over there. Probably gonna trigger the mission to hijack the no, not if we nope. That little corner of the map there apparently does it. Be like, oh, you're too far from the carriage. Yeah, because that's not what I'm trying to do right now, Chief. I guess he doesn't want to. Of course, it reset because I'm not wanting to do that mission right now. Think the game would, I don't know, maybe realize that since I'm nowhere near the objective, that I'm wanting to do it.
To check the back.
All right. Those people disappeared real quick.
I see.
Speak with the doorman, all right. So I think in this one, our main target is supposed to be like the head of the blighters, the rival gang.
I'm here to see Mr. Roth.
Weapons?
No, thank you. I've got my own.
You should be on the stage, sir. This way.
Beach Roth.
Ah, our honored guest has arrived. Come, sit. I've had my eye on you for some time. I find your heroics in battling the great Crawford Starrick quite magnificent.
I've been picking off your soldiers one by one. Doesn't that make you angry?
On the contrary, surprise is a spice of life. Now, Mr. Starrick, that's a different story. I'm drowning in directives, all terribly boring. Let's say we work together and bring him down.
I'm not so sure about that.
My friend, if I fail to provide you with the chance to cause Starek some pain, well, you can charge into this theater and kill me yourself.
What do you get out of all this?
The chance to have a little fun with the bravest man in London.
You have a deal.
Lewis! My carriage! Shall we? This way.
All right.
Well, you don't expect
we maybe get through a gate? Jesus.
Take the reins. Driver, to St. Pancras. And don't spare the horses.
I don't even know who the hell this guy is.
Starek would be fighting for the same ends. What happened?
Or is he the head of the...
You know. He required my services to train his gang leaders. But the man is dreadful.
Oh, is he he's done with the gang life, maybe? I don't know.
Freedom, Jake. Stealing that...
The story is all kind of nebulous.
It denies us our humanity.
I have no idea what the fuck is going on for most of this.
And St. Pancras will ease our suffering?
The station contains a large shipment of explosives to be dispatched to Starek and Co.
And you intend to steal it?
What? No! I intend to blow it up! Yes! There's a train parked inside St. Pancras.
Then I'm to do away with Starek's merchandise, leaving chaos in my wake?
Why not, Jacob? Why not? As we speak, the up train is headed towards us. That may help you enter the station unseen.
As long as it remains on the tracks.
I'd say good luck, but you don't need it. I shall make certain any reinforcements from Starek are kept away from the station.
Damn, using the moving train, is this gonna count for my objective, or do I have to, like, wait till I'm there? Holy shit, that's a bunch of dudes. Alright. Destroy all dynamite by igniting it. Alright. Okay, so the... Destroy the destroy all dynamite by igniting it is the second... is the secondary objective, but our thing is to destroy the what? Why are they doubling down on the... I have no idea some of the decisions in this game. Right? And I'll run away from the explosion.
Someday you blighters will understand that I'm doing this for your own good.
Not even gonna freak out about it? Alright. Well, let's run and destroy the alarm bell. Have shit, lady. Anybody else want some fun? There ain't no fun if the homies can't have none. Song goes. I'm not sure why I didn't do that before. Surprised more guys didn't come running. There's a cop next to those ones. Stop now. Hey, McGee, do your thing, man. I appreciate the lurk. You're having a good Tuesday? All the snipers in the game are women. I don't know if there's a reason for that, or I guess saves time on modeling, or like that, maybe. Okay, don't know why I lost my combo. Right, there we go. Wondering why it was taking so long to get the multi-kill finisher going. What blows my mind is that they see me fuck up like a dozen of their friends and then they still try to fight me. Which the same could be said for the movie Nobody that I saw earlier. He just goes around, like, absolutely wrecking guys. And more of them just come after him. Only, like, two people in the movie are like, you know what? Have a good day, sir. I'm going to stay out of your way. They know better than to get involved with somebody who's just going to go John Wick on them. Killing your friends and blowing shit up. Don't act so surprised. Alright, there we go. I don't know what's special about the guys with the gold, unless they're like supposed to be the boss men or something, maybe. Did I not? I thought I dismantled the alarm bell. But it's just still showing up on the map, I guess. Okay, I think if I like shot the dynamite or something, that would be the other way. Destroying it.
Now to find somebody to drive this hunk of metal.
Find a driver, alright. Ryan Gosling available? Partially deaf kid from Baby Driver? A-B-Y Baby? An exit from this nightmare?
Created too much noise. I'll need to keep a low profile.
You just blew up five things of dynamite. How is that not creating a little bit of noise? Alright. Okay, where's the chest? Up above? Oh, I guess I kidnap him to drive for me? I feel like that would result in him, I don't know, crashing maybe? How am I supposed to get over there? Literally here the whole time. Oh, apparently he wasn't. Right, reach the locomotive with the driver.
Get your bleeding hands off me! What do you think you're up to?
Hush now, please. Do be quiet, sir. No need to make a fuss.
What do you want from me?
I just need you to keep the engine stoked.
All right, I'll help you. Don't hurt me. All right.
What the hell was that?
All right, I'll help you. Don't hurt me.
You can't even... Oh, my God.
All right, I'll help you. Don't hurt me.
Think of me as another passenger. I just happen to have a rather large blade pointed at your back.
How to win friends and influence people. Put a knife on them. No. Apparently can't take any steps at all. Penguin, how's it going? Welcome back. Doing well. Did you get a lot done during the double XP weekend? For COD? Probably went up like 12 or 13 levels on my season pass.
Would you be so kind as to get some steam?
I'm sorry to hear that, man. I hope things are looking up. I know what that's like. I've been okay. I was really sick on Thursday and Friday. And then was recovering Saturday and Sunday. Just, I did not have a good reaction to my second shot. So, yeah, I did not stream till yesterday? I think yesterday. Sunday. All the days run together now. Yeah, I know what you mean of just kind of shutting down and not feeling it for doing the things you normally like to do. Hope things get better. Let's see. Probably don't have any money to pick up in the whatchamacallit train. At this point. Forgot that I got the upgraded version. That's better than the gun that I had been working with. Don't really use the gun all that much. I took my grandpa to the movies for the first time since last February, so I'm in a really good mood. been wanting to do that for so long, and he's been wanting to go for so long, and it's just been really nice to be able to do that again. Go back to some kind of normalcy from what life has been like. We saw Nobody, the Bob Odenkirk from Breaking Bad and Better Call Saul. Basically, imagine kind of like John Wick movie, but the main character is like a suburban dad. It was really cool. Funny and really funny, really violent. So my grandpa enjoyed it. And we're going to go see another one on or later in the week as well. He's vaccinated, I'm vaccinated, and the movie theaters are open again. It's been wanting to go. It's really good. It's highly recommend it. If you like the John Wick movies, the fun twist on them. Bob Odenkirk is just such a fantastic actor with incredible range. Just weird to see him in an action role. Having seen him play, you know, kind of the comic relief on Breaking Bad, and then like all the dramatic stuff he does for Better Call Saul. Seeing him basically destroy people like Liam Neeson or Keanu Reeves is a real trick. How's this game going? Do I like it? It's okay. I'm liking it more than the last few Assassin's Creeds I've tried. But there's some weird design choices and some missions that really suck. The ones where you have to hail people. And then some of the mechanics when it comes to driving, rough. One of the ones you just straight skipped. It played 1 and 2. And then I tried Black Flag, but I didn't get a feel for the pirate ship stuff. I tried Origins, but got distracted by other games. And then, but I love this time period, so I figured this would help. And I've had it lying around forever in my backlog. And I'm enjoying it so far. I have no idea what the hell is going on in the story, but I'm still getting some enjoyment out of it. Do you have a favorite in the Assassin's Creed series?
Jacob. He is beautiful, isn't he? I planned a perfect second outing for us.
Have you?
There's borrowing to be done. 3 of Starek's henchmen are about to disappear.
Oh, you sly devil.
Oh, and I'm coming along this time. There is no sense in giving you all the glory. Off to my carriage we go, Lewis!
Kind of want to go back to Origins just because as a kid, I loved Egypt, ancient Egypt, and I loved ancient Greece, so I love the time periods. Just the execution of some of the mechanics in games have been bad, but I played the first one like right when it came out. My roommate had gotten it on release, and I played through it completely. And then the second one is the one that I've gotten. I got the full completion of it, but that was almost a decade ago, so the memory of it's a little hazy of all the lore and everything. But the modern day story isn't as fun for me as the historical stuff, I guess. Well, the DLC for Origins.
Bring your carriage around.
I shan't be very long. I got the DLC for this one because it was on sale, and it's Jack the Ripper. And Jack the Ripper was one of the things that got me to true crime originally as a kid. So heard it's really, really good. Mummies and Tombs of Anubis are so cool. I really loved Indiana Jones and the Mummy movie with Brendan Fraser, so I would totally be into that kind of stuff. She benched a statue not far from here. Right?
The statue must be around here somewhere.
I know the DLC for Odyssey, the Greek one, was supposed to be really good too. Alright, how do I examine this without him pop freaking out?
I was to meet my brother here, but I see no sign of him.
Now where right? is that statue?
Bless you, madam.
Alright, let's talk to the youth here.
Hey, Smalley. Know anything about what happened here?
A story painted it, sir.
Miss Cadwallader?
She odds down the sewers, sir.
Oh, they actually have boss fights? Come
now. No need of course it's sewers.
Alright, how do I get to the... Dude, I'm not even in the restricted zone. Chill out. I'm not murdering anyone because I'm trying to do the all the secondary objectives, which will allow me to get full synchronization for one of the achievements. How do all the cops in London apparently have parkour skills? Mommy's supposed to be its own. Oh man. Assuming they're not, you know, dusty mummies. They're more like kind of the one from the movies. Entrance to the basement. I gotcha. Don't worry. What? They throw darts at you? I will say, I do like the throwing knives and stuff like that.
Why
games.
The bloody sewers?
I like the kind of stealthy kind of stuff. How am I supposed to track that guy? Looking right at me. Can I upgrade any of my skills here? 4 points. I'm not going to upgrade anything right now. And like right at me, what am I supposed to do here? Alright, so maybe I run this way and he'll chase me and I can knock him out?
I found you, boy! When I find you, I will kill you! I won't lose you this time!
Or apparently I can not. You can't walk off ledges in this one. Or the guided arrow. Yeah, I remember I got to that part at least. So extra. So ridiculous.
Rest in peace, friend.
Rest in peace, friend. Yeah, the controllable arrow reminded me of the Slayer guided rocket launcher in Perfect Dark. Okay, let me. I want to dispose of these guys before I worry about kidnapping her. I don't have to fight my way out. Right now he's looking the way I wanted him to look at before. I'll avenge you. Alright, hopefully I can get past about these jabronis. Kick her in the face, apparently? Alright.
Tell Mr. Starrick his next delivery is on its way. And tell him too that
oh, that's a lockpick one. I will come back and do that later.
Wasn't Starrick who sent me.
Then who?
Maxwell Roth sent his regards.
Real trick is gonna be getting her out of here without the cops freaking out. Keep looking that way, officer.
Is everything all right? You seem distracted.
What? Oh, no. Terribly sorry. I'll send my brother here.
Go around this way. You're very observant, child.
Why, Miss Cadwallon? What a pleasant surprise.
You'll be hearing from Mr. Starrick, Roth.
I look forward to it.
Son.
I reached St. James Park. Oh. Well, you don't have to go. I can just go with him.
Why the Alhambra?
Every good criminal needs a place to invest his ill-gotten gains. And what's better than distracting the world with a little light entertainment while you do so?
Oh, come now. You can't tell me you don't enjoy the triumph of a well-received play. The plaudits and praise, the reviews.
I enjoy being entertained, Jacob. If one of the productions pleases me, I am over the moon.
Okay, so the gang leader controls, theaters in London? Because he's classy.
Benjamin Raffles. Those who cross him tend to disappear without warning.
Sounds like we'll be fast friends.
Be careful. His guards are never far away.
All right, this is gonna be a little trickier. There's the haystack. I don't know if there's anything that will allow me to parkour on or get to the zip or zipline, the whatever it's called, leap of faith area. Any plans for Easter? No, not really. What about you? Holidays are weird right now. Okay, so the carriage counts as the enemy target area, I guess. That's why it keeps circle keeps flicking around. Nothing, hopefully. I'm not really a religious person, so more of a, you know, time for family for me. All right, I should be able to blend in with the people here. Once he comes back this way, we can then, should be pretty easy to get out that way. As long as we avoid all the guards.
Your villains mixed up, Mr. Raffles. The man you work for is the real villain here.
Oh, this is gonna be tricky. I'm gonna have to take the long way around to get back to the carriage. They've got the patrolling carts. soon as this guy goes by, we'll have to book it to the corner. Hopefully not run into any walls. Shit. Alright, you're not freaking out about me walking here. As long as the circle is small, then I think I'll be okay. Those are regular civilians there, I think. Oh, not regular civilians. He's got a good sense of self-preservation. He's not freaking out and yelling at the dudes when they're driving by. Hey, Gypsy, how's it going? The
most fragrant raffles. How very good to see you.
Hopefully, you're able to fix the Joy-Con okay. And thank you again for that list of Switch games for me to get my friend.
Who is this Lewis that works for you?
Oh, Christ. Ha! A bit of an odd fish, isn't he? Came to me a few years past.
He's very solemn.
But always so polite. And he has many other talents.
Swapped parts and have replacements on the way. That, I think you said last night, it's nice that you know tech stuff so that you're able to do your own repairs.
A copper by day and snitch by night. Remove him from the pack. And you cut Starrick's ties to the police force.
Must be good at what he does to keep the charade going for so long.
He is indeed, dear boy.
You, I'm assuming are playing Eden today? $10 in 10 minutes better than the $70? Yeah. Remember, I once had to send my PlayStation 2 in to get fixed.
Whoa, easy.
And that was kind of a nightmare.
Welcome to Scotland Yard.
Oh, and we have to go into the police force to kidnap the corrupt police officer. Right. Should be challenging. Oh, separate ways on Resident Evil 4. I really like that. Playing as Ada, and you get to see all the things she did along the way for to make Leon's life easier. I love when games, and well, anything really, show you mix between, or you know, different angles of another, of the same story. How many plot holes it creates? It's been a while since I've played it, so my memory of it, it's hazy. But plots in those games otherwise are pretty ridiculous. Let's see. Here. Oh, in the HD remaster, they didn't even bother to fix that up. Dude, I didn't kill anyone. I just knocked him out. I'm a pacifist here. Okay, how am I supposed to get up? Oh, there's the stairs.
Desist.
God, let me alone. I'll do anything. Just please let me go.
What's all this, sir?
Alright. Nap him.
What? Let me live.
Now, Swineborn. Let's not make a scene.
You're not going to get away with this.
Oh, but I am.
Where are you taking me?
A friend would like to say a quick how do you do.
All right, gonna go very carefully here. Nice and slow.
What's all that then?
Who's gonna look after me? Listen,
you wouldn't put down a useful dog, would you? I'll do anything you want.
Nice and slow. Oh, is that a dead end? Shit. All right, let's see if we can get out through this area. I will say, I do like that they give the extra challenge here of not letting you emote it by assassinating everyone. Not assassinating them, murdering them. They'll think it's weird. They'll just a lowly goon, it's considered assassination, but I'm just, how did they come up on me? Because assassination is supposed to be, you know, taking somebody out for political or reasons, basically, to send a message. But if you're just doing it with on a little goon, some low-level gang member, it really count. Oh, to start all the way back here. It'll be better if I take out the guy on that from that end so that I can just go down the stairs easily. Alright, go back to the window there. Come on, you can do it.
You can see how he's misspent his youth.
Right.
Some of us have to work instead of fuck.
Someone's up to no good.
All right. We almost made it out of this mission on the first try. Delph Queen. Why did it? I was trying to knock him out and it just released him. Game man. For all the things it does right, some of the controls are really finicky.
Someone's up to no good.
I wonder what all the archibalds are about.
All right, let's walk him over here. Let him take a nap. Oh, since I already looted it. Okay. That makes sense. I guess it saved, I'd looted it, but it didn't save, that I was in the area.
Oh.
Now, Swain.
All right.
Let's not make a scene.
You're not going to get away with this.
Oh, but I am.
I'm just like slowly moving the left stick.
A friend would like to say a quick how do you do.
I could like knock him out and throw him over my shoulder, then just climb out the window. Right now, walk away. So I need to be very careful here because I still have no idea how those guys just popped out of nowhere. Okay, if I can take a left here and get out, then I should be okay. I think going to the right was what did me in. It looks like that does exit out onto the street. As soon as he walks by, yeah, it does. All right. As soon as he walks the other way, then okay. So if we're just standing still, somehow the circle of detection opens up more. It's because it's maybe suspicious that we're just standing still. Right. Now. Two dudes out for a walk. Gonna see here. Objective's cleared, so now I don't have to worry about that anymore.
Walk on, girl. Let's go.
There we go.
Excellent work. Do come find me at the Alhambra. I have more amusements planned for us.
All right, let's should be able to go back to the train, collect more money. It's been over half an hour. I can find the train. Sometimes it doesn't even show up on the map, which is kind of dumb, but maybe if we do a one of the strongholds or contracts, it'll let us go to the train. Is that a bounty hunt? Templar hunts are here. Then 5 points. I'll still hold on to the points. And I don't need to buy to refill anything because I haven't murdered anyone. What even is this? D. Oh, Charles Darwin, okay. I don't want to do a Charles Darwin mission right now. There's a Charles Dickens, Charles Darwin. I think there's a Karl Marx side quest as well. Okay. Like, I don't know what this restricted area is. Kill the target using explosives. From now on, and I guess I could shoot and blow up one of the dynamite crates, but I don't want to get a civilian in the process. Sorry, I just got a Discord message. Didn't know if it was important to respond to right away, but it is not. Let's see. Hoping you can find your Fallout 3 disc. Do you have Game Pass? Because you should be able to get it for free. Game Pass on EA Play. Alright, so much for blowing the guy up with explosives. Oh, okay. Yeah, I have it. I got the Game of the Year edition when I bought Fallout 4. Came with the code of it. Yeah, for sure. I don't blame you. I borrowed Fallout 3 when I first got a Xbox 360. I played like an hour of it and gave it back to my friend. It wasn't my thing at the time. Choo-choo train. Does it just disappear? Alright, well, I guess we're not collecting our money right now then. Do the mission, move on with our lives. No, I don't want to drive. Let me drop off of the thing. I was told I should play New Vegas before 3, though. If I was going to play any of them, it'd be New Vegas. You should. What are you doing? Lady, I'm here to see your boss. That code to a friend, you're a good friend. Do I get any money? Knives from this guy?
This way, my dear. I've something to show you. Hop in.
Where are we going?
One of Starrick's workshops, where they build weapons for his army. When the world is full of nasty things...
Alright, hopefully we don't have, another one of those don't kill people objectives, because that would make my life miserable. It takes so much longer to do it fine with playing stealth, but I also like the opportunity if things go sideways to, things go sideways, I can still, finish it up somehow.
Funkin' you.
You must see the potential, dear Jacob. This workshop is one of Starrick's,
set the dynamite, and let's blow it to atoms. Together.
All right. See. All right. Don't kill anyone. We'll place the explosives. Fuck me. All right. Well, let's see if I can go around and knock people out first. Especially the snipers make this nightmare. Alright, go to sleep, my angel. Another one there. There. Alright, best way to get over to them. Gonna stay in that corner. Why is it not? There we go. Oh, she was unconscious, but she rolled off and she didn't die. All right, well, I didn't kill her. Alright. Oh man, and somebody who I was surprised to see in the movie today, who I haven't seen in a movie in forever, was Michael Ironside. Did the voice of Sam Fisher. Talk about a Ubisoft title that needs to come back is Splinter Cell games. Michael Ironside's voice is just something incredible. Oh, oops, no, I'm sorry. Didn't see you over there either, sir. It turns around, I'll... out. How are you supposed to get the guys like that? Oh, is it because that was one of the boss guys that he freaked out and took off? All right, that makes sense. Some of these guys have a sense of self-preservation. You cannot fill me with holes, sir. That's not something I want done. You can't do that without my consent. She could like do a knockout takedown rather than just like assassinate people, but like no. Hug them and hug them too hard. Like Lenny from Of Mice and Men.
You stop that, or I'll make you stop.
He's glitched out there. And
what's going on over here?
Here, you can find out. Yeah. Oh, in the Assassin's Creed movie. Of Mice and Men, the one with Gary Sinise and John Malkovich. It's one I remember we watched in high school. We read it with Sherilyn Fenn from Twin Peaks as Candy's wife. Candy was like the lead boss guy, I think. And it's literally been almost 20 years since I've read that book. Actually, yeah, I did read that freshman year. But you read it and watched the end scene? Yeah, that was one of those things where, watched the whole movie because the teacher had a sub. It was basically any day that we had a sub, he would have us watch a movie, which as a teacher now, I can see that he was just making life easy for himself and for the sub. All right, can I just lure you here?
Noises.
lost another good one. Goodness. What is this? Good riddance. The assassins must be near.
Why did it not let me... Yeah, that scene is always, it's so rough. He's like, totally loves Lenny, but he also knows that Lenny's too dangerous. And I don't know if you know much about treatment of the developmentally disabled in the old days, but it was basically throw them in jail. It was pretty much throwing them in jail, and they would just, you know, people would just throw shit at each other in jail. That's how things were up until, in most mental institutions or places, they would just put people who were mentally disabled in those kind of asylums. And it wasn't until the Reagan era that it was kind of treated them like the human beings that they are. Which, fucking depressing to think about. That's fair, yeah. In the book, you know, that's one of the things with books, you can show more of that character's internal struggle, which is really hard to put out on film. Can't really show the internal motivation all that well. You away from your spot there, sir. Yeah, and there's ways to do that, but not all films are done all that subtly when it comes to those things. Kind of like a remember the Great Gatsby version with Robert Redford that we watched that year as well? Is nowhere near as nuanced the book. Climb up? Where'd he go?
Oh, you won't escape again. Can't hide from me, boy. I won't miss.
Sir, I'm trying to spare your life here. Have you zero chill? Have to keep reminding myself this is for an achievement, this is for the completion.
There's nothing we can do to get him now.
I feel like the rain, it's a nice touch. Exactly, yeah. Show his hand and the gun shaking, show the pain on his face rather than just pop, pop in the back of the head. Summary execution style.
I'll teach you a fucking lesson.
I want to be taught a lesson. I'm on vacation.
I'm coming for you.
Study film on how to do this shit. Do you go to film school as well? How have we not talked about that before? Oh, you took classes in a number of things for, okay. Your degree's not fully in, it's not like a BA in film. Mythology, digital design. I really enjoy mythology as well. Oh, you don't? Oh. You think you'll ever want to go back and get one, or? I was talking to a friend who's a, he teaches English writing in college. Talking to her about how much I miss being able to learn and study stuff that I'm fascinated by with other people who are fascinated by it. That's fair. Yeah, that, you know, it's a waste of money. But I mean, I think the big part of it for me was I knew that I would have to have a degree of some kind, get a job, get my 4-year degree. So I
that's one.
Don't feel bad about that. Even though I didn't go into film. Also, I couldn't have gotten, you know, I couldn't have gone to grad school to get my teaching credential without having had a 4-year credential.
There.
Obviously, for a doctor or lawyer, it doesn't carry over, but not for most things, yeah. So I have been able to teach film before. So it was nice to be able to do that as well. Even though I don't, you know, teach film full time. That'd be the dream, though.
And done.
The name
is an elective like that where you know that.
James Bond.
Jerry65, thank you so much for the follow. You're having a great Tuesday. Like, teaching electives would love to do that, but just, well, even especially now during the pandemic, it's really hard to get funding and stuff for elective classes, unfortunately. I want to talk about a useless degree, though. Sister, bless her heart, she got her degree in philosophy, and she's not doing anything in philosophy for work. All right, how do I? Where's the golden crate chest thing that I need to? Oh, it's in the sewers? I'm not gonna worry about that then. Oh, he's on the roof. I forgot. It's so long because I've been taking my time not murdering people.
All rigged up.
Perfect.
Two trimesters for one class? Jeez.
Stand back. Ready!
Wait!
Whatever for?
There are children in there.
Jacob, my dear. Starek uses child labor to manufacture goods. We must put an end to his production line.
But not like this.
Why not? I can do whatever I damn well please. Soon, you will understand what it is to be free, as I am. Light him up, boys! No! What the hell are you doing?
We're not playing games anymore, Roth!
No. We're not.
Okay. Where am I supposed to rescue the children? Three kids that I need to carry out. Oh, really? All right, child. I really hope that it's only these kids that I have to drop off here. Oh, now he wakes up and is able to run. Okay.
Somebody went down one of his routes.
Oh. Ooh, what a dick.
A gift, sir, from Mr. Roth. You should be warned, Mr. Fry, that when Roth is angry with one, he generally brings suffering to many.
Dearest Jacob, alas, it seems our adventures together have come to a close. Although our time together was brief, it's left a lasting mark. I wish you well in all your future endeavors. Cordially, Maxwell. Post
going back in the fire for taking the injury. This evening.
All of London will be there.
It could be that he was just, please find your invitation. In shock. Oh, okay. I got a dead bird. A present? That's a weird present. Alright, is it gonna give us the... Let us go to the train to collect our money, hopefully. Wrong button. Where's the train? There, finally. money, money, money. That should be enough. Oh, more than enough. Buy last thing here. That's going to give us a whole ton of cash. And then let's see. We're level 8. I need to spend 7 skill points to reach the next level. Let's, that. All right, can I switch to Eevee now? Level her up. That one. And actually, yeah, this one. Really, no, because it executes better, because that will help you get them to the point where you're the multi-finisher, I believe. Let's do and inventory. Fine. Can I craft? Nope, I don't have a black diamond. I don't know if I want to upgrade that yet. Preview. And like the Titan Mark class item from Destiny, and a little cape thing that hangs off the backside. And then our mission here. You know, it's going to be a showdown between Jacob and Roth. But it'll auto swap Jacob once I get there. Actually, now it's not really even worth it to fast travel by the time it loads and all that. We can, let's see, refill our money here. Or not refill our money, refill our equipment.
Have a good day now.
We'll do this mission. And we'll should wrap up section 8 here. And section 9, which is the last one. Probably I won't finish it tonight, obviously. Let's see how this goes. All right. Right, let's get a. Let's find the picture here.
Masks only.
Put a mask from Roth's guard near the music hall, alright?
This entrance is for masks only.
No mask, no entry. Wait, where's the music hall?
Join this group.
I believe that Corvus is Latin for crow.
I've never come across a title. What do you suppose?
The doors will open shortly. Please
in
on your
times,
mask.
The crow was known to be a trickster of sorts, much like the fox.
Why can't we go in, sir?
See that man? He only lets people wear masks enter.
Let's see if we. Got a mask. Can I just steal his mask? Can I do a, let's see if I can do a dual takedown here. Right now, that's gonna let me
yes,
slow slip on in with my fancy little mask. That guy dressed like a Union soldier. He's in London. All right, Usher. Let it burn and get on in. All right, I don't know what started that all. Why the fisticuffs happened. Hopefully it saved me having the mask. Nope, apparently not.
The West End has certainly come into its own this season.
Eliza, is that really you? Aren't these masks? Saying follow the usher to enter the music hall. Am I gonna mask on or?
I believe that Corvus is Latin for crow.
Alright, well, I'm gonna have to just go murk these guys again.
Masks only. I repeat, ladies and gentlemen, this entrance is for masks only.
Let's make a mess!
Right.
He's definitely up to something. That's the last mistake you'll ever make.
Why is he triggered by me already? Because I was not in the circle, I guess.
Everyone ready?
Quite freaked out.
Then let's proceed.
Mesdames et messieurs, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Alhambra Music Hall. Tonight,
Alhambra? It's not Alhambra? The water?
Only, a very special performance of Corvus the Trickster. While some of the effects may be visceral and highly disturbing, do not be alarmed, my good people. Fear not. This is a purest form of entertainment. Tonight's performance immortalizes and is for the benefit of a young fellow very near and dear to my heart.
Any he's doing this for me? Sweet.
To him. Jacob, dear boy, tonight is for you.
She's a rare gem, that one. I do admire her bravery.
This sort of evening is quite to her taste, sir.
I don't know why I had to get all dramatic there and climb up on the railing, but...
I'll be serving you this evening, gentlemen.
You're still here, love. Last time, I swear, you nearly poisoned us.
Scene two, stand by!
Alright, so, okay, so he's got multiple goons. Where's the,
We have a volunteer.
Waitress.
A big round of applause.
Oh, right there.
Man. Our volunteer is about to die for you. Jacob.
What a brave soul going up on stage like
you
that.
You lucky people are about to witness this gentleman being fired upon at point blank range. Our performer will hit several targets placed around his head. Exciting, is it not? Will our honored guest go unharmed? We British are a hardy bunch. Let's put that hardiness to the test.
All right, if those guys stand close enough, be able to, I'm probably not close here. There's, okay.
Please stay with us as we prepare for the next turn.
You know what? That rough fella can go hang himself.
Oh my.
Don't say it. You know he's...
Excuse me, love. Just looking for the lavatory.
Who's over there?
Thanks.
That's your poison the gang? All right, will do. Oh, it was just a hallucinogenic dart, I guess, that I put in the pitcher, and they're gonna kill each other. Right? The poison's just gonna take out the rest of them.
The hunt now a search for want rather than need.
Okay, she's gonna do the same over here, I guess. That's why the objective's still there.
We found a suitably flat-headed gentleman for this one. You laugh, ladies and gentlemen, but I assure you that is the case.
You have a flat head, Michael.
What? I have no doubt that you could hazard a guess as to what this one concerns, my friends. Our courageous participant hasn't even flinched.
All right.
Standing a few feet away, our performer expertly throws his knives at the apple, slicing
it. Goes that. Now, how do we do the others?
Willie or won't he?
That's the way.
All right, that guy looks like he's all alone, so I can just walk up and slowly just, get him. Oh, that person's standing on a table. There's one of those kind of people at a party.
Is he?
The search consumed. Creed forgotten. Prey visualized. Laugh watering.
Alright, well. We just need to get downstairs. Hit that guy and then free the dude that they kidnapped.
Don't kill me, please.
I don't want to die. Have mercy.
Why are they freaking out about me? They see me do anything. Alright, that was easy.
You know what? That rough fella can go hang himself.
Mary, don't say that.
You know he's no good, Jim. Don't treat any of us right, you don't.
In your mouth, doesn't it? Like eating pork when expecting venison.
Where's the machinist here?
Volunteer in the box. The celebrated illusionist will proceed to saw him in half. Watch as our esteemed guest emerges unharmed. Our skilled illusionist, Sabretooth Jane, is performing this famous trick. She is said to have studied at the feet of the mysterious Perini himself. The saw Miss Jane is using this evening is imported from the ancient city of Cordumenum, celebrated for manufacturing the finest steel in the world.
Snap his bloody neck.
All right, well.
Show yourself.
I hope you have enjoyed your evening so far, ladies and gentlemen. I know I have. Now, before our final act, I would like to toast all you brave people who joined us tonight to celebrate life and death. Go on, toast them! Your move, Jacob, my dear! Burn! 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 Jacob, my dear, where are you?
That's a daisy. Tom Watchley.
Wait for him to lower the rafter. Cut the rope to assassinate Roth, alright? How do I cut the rope? I want to drop down that side, thank you. Oh, okay, it's not making me.
Baby crow's neck between my thumb and forefinger. Slice to bits the ones you deem innocent. Keep the world in its divine manic state. For the same reason I do anything.
He's fucking crazy?
Why not?
Oh, alright, well, I guess he's Victorian Joker. That was definitely under 90 seconds. Maximum Dracula schematic. I have no idea what a Maximum Dracula is. I'm assuming it's a weapon of some kind.
City will die. Tupine has failed. Lucy has failed. Brudenell, Elliotson, Pearl. All have gone into the night. It is up to me now. The assassins have brought nature's fury into our homes. Men have become monsters, barreling toward us, teeth out. Our civilization must survive this onslaught.
You know he's evil because he's got that mustache.
I will start anew. London must be reborn.
The Peace of Eden is under Buckingham Palace. We've got all we need. Let's start planning our infiltration.
Hold on. Better to get visual verification. If we're going to move, we need to be 100% sure. We'll only get one shot before Otso Berg crashes down on us.
Gotta agree with Sean.
We'll position ourselves near the palace, but we'll wait for you to sync the genetic data before we move.
It's all up to you, Initiate.
So, they've been very hands-off with the modern-day stuff so far. It's basically little glimpses, but for whatever reason, they're using me because I have ancestral DNA twins.
Starrick is making his move. The Peace of Eden is somewhere inside Buckingham Palace.
Let him have it.
I've seen your handiwork across the city. Perhaps you should trust my judgment.
I've been killing Starrick's henchmen. What have you been doing? Let's ask Henry, shall we?
I have been repairing your mistakes. Too much haste is too little speed.
Don't you quote father at me.
That's Plato. And I am sorry, this doesn't involve anything you can destroy. Father was right, he never approved of your methods.
Father is dead!
Enough! I have just received word from my spies. At the palace ball tonight, Starrick plans to steal the Peace of Eden, and then eliminate all the heads of church and state.
Once more for old time's sake?
And then we're finished.
Agreed. So what's the plan?
Such an unexpected delight to visit you both. What is the news on the street?
Mrs. Disraeli, we have discovered that there is something inside Buckingham Palace that could threaten the...
He's the one we took on a trip to the...
Failing to say is that we require entry pretty parts of town tonight.
Well, impossible! Even if there were any invitation cards remaining, which there are not, someone of your lowly station...
If that damn fool Gladstone is attending this evening, they can have my card. Perfect. Then I'll go alone.
Mrs. Disraeli, if you would be kind enough to inform my darling brother of the location of the Gladstone's residence, perhaps he could use his considerable skills to commandeer their cards.
What fun! Did you hear that, Dizzy? We're going to pinch the Gladstone's invitations.
Thank you for volunteering me, sweet sister.
Oh, a pleasure, brother, dearest. Now, Mrs. Disraeli, if you would excuse me, I must visit with the Maharaja. It occurs to me that he may have a second set of plans to a certain vault.
All right, there's probably no money.
Treating me like a child.
Maybe there's money. Hopefully there's money. Yep, there is some money. All right. How many skill points do we have here? This will put me over to level 9. Not enough to buy that. So in total I need 14 more skill points. Max him out. Sure, that will have him hit level 10. That should be easy enough to do while I'm clearing the rest of the map. If you are watching this on YouTube, thank you for watching on YouTube. I'm going to end the recording here, and the next video will be the end of the game. So thank you for watching.